As we narrow in on Election Day, both former President Trump and Vice President Harris are ramping up appearances in pivotal states. Trump takes the stage in Atlanta, and Harris was interviewed by radio host Charlemagne the God in Detroit today after rallies for both of them in Pennsylvania yesterday. In Minnesota, a pivotal district, one could argue, is St. Cloud. Last election, both the Minnesota Senate and House races in the 14th district were decided by a margin of less than 5%. It was also the location for a Trump rally last July. Now, the city of St. Cloud is saying the Trump campaign still owes them $209,000 incurred while they were there, and the deadline to pay has passed. Heidi Wigdahl is here to explain who owes what to whom. Hey, Heidi.
Yeah, Rena, the Trump campaign did pay St. Cloud State University for using its venue, but that's not owned by the city. The city says they're still waiting to be reimbursed for all the extra public safety costs, and this is not a new problem.
President Donald Trump campaigned in St. Cloud in July. He brought more than 8,000 supporters inside the National Hockey Center at St. Cloud State University and more crowds outside. The event also brought more than $200,000 in costs that the city is now trying to recover.
If I was running for re-election and I had a cost of a rally that I did that was well over $200,000 for the city, I'd feel an obligation to pay the city, and so I would do that.
St. Cloud Mayor Dave Kleiss, who also served in the Minnesota State Senate from 1995 to 2005 as a Republican, says the first notice was invoiced to the Trump campaign in September with 30 days to pay.
Have you heard from the campaign at all?
We have not, and you know, this is that's why we send the second invoice.
Costs include police $63,000, public services $60,000, fire $21,000, IT $1,800, and nearly $62,000 for a construction change order where Secret Service required they open a roundabout.
And it was actually pretty strong, or a pretty quick turnaround, and you don't know those costs until it's over, because Secret Service requires a lot of changes.
An NBC News report says at least four cities and a county are still waiting to be reimbursed for Trump campaign visits, seeking more than $750,000 in unpaid bills. Our Verify team says it's unclear, however, whether Trump is legally obligated to pay all of them. The Center for Public Integrity reported in 2019 that in some cases, there weren't any signed contracts with the campaign, which makes the bills difficult to collect. A Trump campaign official claimed to Care 11 that the, quote, U.S. Secret Service is responsible for local law enforcement and first responder costs. Mayor Kleiss says if the Trump campaign does not pay up after this second notice, they'll then bill Secret Service. But a Secret Service spokesperson told us, quote, state and local law enforcement play a crucial role in our ability to effectively conduct our protective operations. Currently, the U.S. Secret Service lacks a mechanism to reimburse state and local governments for their support during protective events. In recent discussions with congressional leaders, we've identified this as a critical need given the essential role our police and public safety partners play. Trump isn't the only one cities are seeking reimbursement from. NBC reports that the Spokane mayor says Bernie Sanders' campaign still owes about $33,000, while Hillary Clinton owes about $3,000.
Previous the city administration did something very similar, billing to George W. Bush at that time. That was in 2004. And that was for costs above and beyond. We've had campaign visits, but we wouldn't charge for anything that we would have as routine, people that are already working. These are above and beyond costs.
Mayor Kleiss says while the White House is not billed for official events, campaign stops are treated the same as any other event that requires city services.
In the last year, those costs have gone up just based on the fact that there was an assassination attempt that increased the amount of security that was used.
Kleiss says they will not compromise on public safety.
We do have an obligation, you know, for our taxpayers to, when there are costs that go above and beyond, to have somebody that is held responsible for that. And that's what we're doing.
Minneapolis went through this after Trump held a rally at the Target Center in 2019. Mayor Jacob Frey tried charging Trump's campaign more than $500,000 for city services. Ultimately, the city reached a settlement with the operators of Target Center, who agreed to pay the city $100,000. The city told Care 11 today that the last payment was processed at the end of last December. Rena.
Has anything changed since then, Heidi?
Yeah, so Mayor Frey did say from now on the city will discuss security costs in advance with venue operators and will be able to charge upfront.